us. The town of Celebration had not quite recovered from its first ever murder when this morning news came of an intense standoff that came to a tragic end. Early this morning, deputies went inside the home of 52-year-old Craig Fauché and found him dead. West 2's Michelle Merrith with the late-breaking details.
It's never happened here in Celebration, but inside a one-week period, two people have died tragically. A body bag coming out of a home. Grief-stricken parents clutching to each other for support. This can't be seen from the usually picture postcard perfect town of Celebration, but this week it is. The latest tragic twist came early this morning. A standoff with Osceola County Sheriff's deputies ended at 2:30 when deputies found 52-year-old Craig Fauché dead.
Several times throughout the evening, there were shots fired, and those shots were fired by Fauché. At no time did deputies return fire.
After 14 hours of negotiations, deputies gassed his home, went in 2 hours later, and found him dead with an apparent self-inflicted gunshot wound. That ended an intense standoff that included the SWAT team, helicopter, robot, school lockdowns, and neighborhood evacuations.
Wow, this has been a bit of a crazy 36 hours. We live on U Court, and I never thought that when I left for work yesterday, I wouldn't be able to come home until the next day.
And this marks the second death in Celebration in 1 week. On Monday, 58-year-old Matteo Gio Venditto was found murdered in his Celebration apartment. Before this week, Celebration had zero deaths. Created by Disney in the early 90s, Celebration was designed to look like an old-fashioned neighborhood, compact, with a beautiful main street. When the lots went up for sale, people from around the world clamored to buy here. What has changed? Neighbors tell us nothing.
It could happen anywhere. I mean, we're people. You know, people are everywhere. Just because, you know, they live in a nice town, it's, you know, I mean, it's be human beings.
Here in Celebration, the fake snow starts blowing at 6 o'clock and every hour on the hour. Meanwhile, detectives continue to work the murder case because the killer is still at large. In Osceola County, Michelle Merrith, West 2 News.